Hey guys, welcome back. I am traveling to the last speeder port that we will use. I think it's the last one, don't quote me on it. Where we can finish all three of our quests. We can finally finish Kaizen's companion quest, which is only something simple, something quick anyway, so it's fine. But obviously, I think the most annoying one is this bit, which is the finding the Zerka compound, because you have to go to all of these different listening things, or whatever they're called. Anyway, Outpost Thorazin. Thorazin? Thorazin? Thorazin sounds better, so I'm going to say Thorazin. First relay tower. Now, I will say something about this quest. It is identical to the Sith, to the Imperial quest that goes to the same place. They both have a different sort of storyline, but they both end up in the same place via the same method. So even if you're doing the Imperial, you have to go to each of these investigate the first relay tower. There's five of them. There's five relay towers, but they all do exactly the same thing, which I was actually really disappointed with, because it sort of felt like lazy story writing to me. And I feel like I don't pretend to know what it was like in the game studio, but I also think that I work in a game studio. I am an environment artist, so I sort of understand what,
enough of that.
It's not the developer's fault, it's the people funding it. It's just where you don't get enough time to finish, or you have to cut the story, you have to just make these quick, lazy changes because you don't have enough time, you don't have enough funding. And it's really, really sort of upsetting. I'm not here crying about it, but it is upsetting to see that a story-driven game this good is having to cut corners like that. I think it's just a bit disappointing, really. Oh, lots of dead people.
What's happened here? Looks like some sort of massacre. Holiday, don't look.
Listen, Delk, we got broken vaporators, a pile of wounded, and our food stores are almost completely gone.
That lunatic said he was a Jedi and a friend of yours. We trusted him.
You better have a pretty good explanation for why this Master Ares keeps sending sand people out to attack us.
I think Master Ares may be unwell.
Another Jedi? Damn it, Delk. Why do you keep leading them here?
Listen here. We've already lost too much to that Master What's-His-Face and his army of sand people.
So why don't you just leave here, quiet-like, and don't cause any more trouble?
I don't want trouble. Just tell me what's going on.
I'm sorry, Jedi, but our trust is a bit worse for the wear at this point.
Well, Master Ares was nice enough when he came through asking to study the sand people.
But ever since we pointed him to their camp, you could set your chrono by their attacks. We got nothing left!
The Sand People are your enemies, not me.
You suggesting we go out there and attack the Sand People? You want us to get killed?
I promise I'm not working with Master Ares.
Alright. I guess we don't have a choice. I'll draw you out a map. In fact, some of our guys scoped out a side entrance you might be interested in. It's a little less crowded, which could be all the difference. There's something weird about these Sand People. They seem faster and stronger than normal.
Well, I think I know where that is. I'll get some gear together and meet you out there. Maybe provide backup.
You have my gratitude.
Still can't believe the Master Ares I worked with is the same guy who's causing so much trouble.
Okay, so we've got the first quest for today. This is going to be... Yes! Oh my god, thank fuck for that. I hate the hood. I actually really like this top. And if it showed a bit more skin, I would consider using it as our thing. But, it's a bit annoying. Okay, where is the... Okay, slip here. And, are they going to let me go or are they going to tag me? Yeah, they're going to tag me. Guess we'll fight them then.
There must be a weakness.
Okay, so this episode might be a bit confusing. We should finish Tatooine in this episode.
That's quite enough.
But you're probably going to find me switching back and forth between the quests. So try to concentrate, and then you'll be alright. when it's possible, I will give a little update about, like, oh, last time we did this, blah, blah, blah. But what we're doing right now is we're going to search for Master Eris, and we literally just did a quest pertaining his whereabouts. So we're all in Master Ceres's radar at the moment. And I'm just stealthing past everyone because I really cannot be fucked to deal with all of these people. I really want to finish Tatooine in this episode, so I'm just going to speed. Except for these people. Do these people. I did affect the audio again, ever so slightly, because even I just can't get my mic to be louder. And I think it's the battle, it's all of the fighting audio that is masking my voice. I think I'm fine in everything else except when I'm fighting someone. And I have put down the fighting audio, but I don't want to put it down like too far, because part of what makes Star Wars Star Wars is the sound of a lightsaber going, and I don't want to get rid of it. So I'm trying to find a balance, and I'm hoping I've found the balance in this episode, because I can't just keep altering it every single time I turn on my screen capture. So please tell me it's fine. Where am I going now? Straight ahead. Oh, it's up there. Okay. Sad people travel.
Just as I programmed. That's quite enough of that.
I sort of remember this from when I did it on my last Pleely character.
Rowan, Jedi, you're about to witness it. After weeks of work, finally, an end to the darkness. These people, these marvelous, marvelous specimens, have been tested, no, purified, in the crucible of Tatooine's harsh environs. They alone are the hope of the galaxy. Their strength, their society, is the blueprint of our salvation.
Master Eris, you are very ill.
No, not ill at all. They are simple, but long after the Empire and the Republic are gone, these people will remain. Their culture is built around strength. They cut the weak away like a societal cancer. Don't you see? It's the only way.
The Jedi Order has a responsibility to weak and strong alike.
How can I make you understand? They are the ultimate warriors purified by hardship. We must follow their example and cut away everything that would make us weak in the face of our adversaries. The frail, the diseased.
You're not thinking straight. Now, look, I'm sick, Eris. You gonna cast me out too?
I have no choice. We must fortify the Republic with its strongest members and send this army of light out against the darkness.
You're not yourself. These are not your thoughts.
You fools! To oppose me is to reveal your own weakness. You will be cast out.
Okay, let's fight these
now,
bitches.
Just as I programmed.
Oh god, sorry. I clicked off my game onto my other screen and like the audio just went like dead. Apologies. I'm still trying to get used to having two screens and gaming at the same time. It's really quite strange. My hope one day, I really want to get a third screen and be able to do it on all three. So you can only do it in odd numbers, annoyingly. So I can't do it with two screen, which would be really helpful. I would just have my map on the other screen.
No, wait. Before you strike the killing blow, listen to me. I hear Lord Vivica's voice. I've failed him, just as I failed my old friend Porcanus when he died.
Why does everyone mention Porcanus?
I don't know, but I keep thinking about our first mission. Our ill-fated mission to Malachor III. We were all weak. We all came under the thrall of the dark side. We did things we regretted, but Porcanus was our strength. As we tried to escape, I fell behind, and he ran back to save me. He became trapped, We had to leave him. It was my weakness that killed him.
It's hard to lose a friend like that. But you have to move on.
I'm trying to. That is the purpose of this project. Think about it. The Jedi Order spends so much time protecting the helpless and caring for the sick, when we could be fighting the Empire. You must kill me. I was weak on Malachor III, and I'm weak now. But you must take my findings before the Council. Promise me that.
We'll discuss that in a second.
What? What was that? You... He's gone. Somehow you've driven Lord Vivekor away. I no longer hear his voice. I almost wish you hadn't done that.
Of all the ungrateful, impudent... This Jedi saved your life.
Lord Vivekor twisted my mind, and I'm glad to be free of him. Still, my discovery remains. From these sand people, I have learned the key to building the unstoppable army. I feel I must bring these findings to the Republic. Yet, I can't shake this feeling that some truths are best left buried in the sand.
Using this information would mean the sacrifice of every good the Republic stands for.
You're right. These records are no more. Thank you for your guidance, and for saving me from Vivekor's grasp.
Well, Jedi, I'm glad Master Eris is alive and his own self. Best get back to Anchorhead myself. Sandrot's acting up and, well, frankly, sort of miss Darth Nurse's hollering.
Thank you for all you've done.
Good luck with whatever it is you're doing, Jedi. Hope you find this Lord Vivekor.
Okay, so that is pretty much our class quest done on this planet. So now we're going to go and do the first relay tower. So I will speed this because it takes fucking ages to get out of here. So yeah. Turns out I actually wasn't that far from the entrance, so that was only a quick speed. Sand People Huntsman.
Just as I programmed.
God, he came from far away. Where did he come from?
Time for some exercise.
Monday is my day off from the gym, so it's not time for exercise for me.
Dr. Soperin here. We've finished our initial catalog of the cave artifacts, which register as over 20,000 years old. You think that would narrow down the possible creators, wouldn't you? There weren't many societies capable of space travel in that period. But I can't find any society or species that fits these criteria. Even Gree technology isn't comparable. Anyway, Dr. Larrick and I will study the primary device and assign lesser relics to the others to keep them busy. Hopefully, we'll find something useful. Zerka's going to make a fortune off this stuff if we can figure it out. End log.
Okay, so that's the first one, and I will add, it is exactly the same one from the Imperial. Even that bit is exactly the same as well. Because I will stop ranting about that, but yeah, that's the final time I'll say it, but it is exactly the same. Okay, well, we're going to take a bit of a sidestep from doing the relay towers and go and sort out Kaizen's companion quest and with these crate dragons. So I think the general idea is that that dragons do exist in this universe. Oh, I want to get the lore object. I don't think I've ever gotten this one. I didn't know there was one. Yeah. Cool. Okay, let's just get Kaizen with us. Let's talk. This is Dad's boat,
so weird. Shivert Starsuk, Zonkalis, Orla.
Not even the scorekeeper could resist. Kaizen and I have come to honor his father's remains. May we have some privacy? That still doesn't explain why we should have to go. We haven't seen your dusk shadow. Indeed. If you want the glory of a hunt, you must earn it.
What coward? Running away from his own trap? Who does that? I mean, this thing looks scary, but I bet he's pretty easy to kill. Oh no, he has a bit of heft to him. That's not bad, actually. It's harder than some of the Jedi Knights and Sith Lords I've had to kill, which is hilarious. Yeah, he does take a bit of time. Return to Kaizen's bones. What is this? I don't want another hood anyway, so that's fine.
Skocharad mask osla, svetod tranis, kundapolua, your scam pokret, natrasisi, vodartikcha, mortavrapsa, kretas, vajul lambasarsk, varsk potrak, mudraksk, kundapolua.
Okay, that was that. All done. So now we can just continue with investigating the relay tower. So let me just speed this. This one is actually right beside our own outpost, so I could have taken a quick travel to get here, but it seemed like a waste. It's actually interesting because obviously the Imperial comes to this one and they get really close to our base. I imagine that if you play on a PvP map, that this is quite an interesting quest to have to get done, because obviously you've got all of the Republic like safe in their base there.
This is Director Antean speaking. As you know, workers' safety is one of Zerka's top priorities, and we take accidents seriously. Therefore, due to concerns surrounding studies of the device, we are implementing a new policy. Anyone wishing to perform a physical inspection of the device must get written authorization from myself and Dr. Daigo. Research using droids and remote scanners may continue normally. Please note that this does not affect our division's overall schedule.
So the holo transmissions will basically just report what happened in the last hours of the Zerk base before it all went to hell. See, the balloon at the moment is in the general vicinity where you have to jump on it, but I wouldn't get there on time even if I tried. I'm not going to. Oh yeah, the Imperials always hang around this bit. It's great when you're actually Imperial having to do this bit, because it's like you don't actually have to fight them, because they're all green to you.
Organis.
Oh, I forgot I still have Kaizen with me. Where's Darren? Darren's my boy. I need Darren.
I want my concerns on the record before more people get hurt. I'm worried about the device. Its energy readings keep fluctuating, and it appears to be trying to link with the lesser artifacts. I think it's a weapon, maybe a bomb. Soprin's theory about it being a Greenclave creation are inane. We've already got evidence of an ancient alien civilization visiting Tatooine, and they weren't Gree. We've seen similar technology in the Kashyyyk Shadowlands. I'm sure the Infinite Empire is tied to the device's origins, no matter what anyone says, and I'm tired of being ignored.
Ooh, another little snippet. Okay, now we're going to go to the fourth one. Oh, we're further than I thought. Oh, it's literally like right by the place where you have to get on. That's annoying. I must have missed it by like a few minutes. I'd be interested to know, unless it's on its way there, or is it on its way back? I can't tell. No, I think it's on its way back. Yeah, it's just been. Come on. How do you hell do you say that? Skike? Skick? I like the name. I like Skike. Skike sounds cool. So it's going to be Skike. I have hereby dubbed it Skike.
Well, Dr. Lyric is gone. He's put in for a transfer and is heading back to Anchorhead, taking one of the lesser relics with him. Good riddance. He was a pain to work with. Still, Lyric's theory about an ancient infinite empire and a master alien species was fringe science at best. But some of his data makes sense. I'm going to run a new series of tests tomorrow, using a remote arm to open up the device. We'll see where it goes from there.
Oh, the beginning of the end for you, Zerka. Right, let's go over this mound. Towards a balloon. Which is annoyingly that we've missed. Alright, do I have to sell anything? Oh, I didn't actually open this, I forgot. Oh, bear belt, bear hat. But I don't actually wear hats, so that's fine. Let's sell whilst we're at this.
Stand by for
weird
examination
port.
And suggest the product.
Right, no, 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 no.
You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
The Infinite Desiccation. How awesome is that for a name of the place? Yeah, that is the thing you jump on. It must be on its way. Or maybe it's just been. But that building that I pointed to, but I don't. Yeah, this one, I think, is one of the places where you can stand to get on it. I could have sworn it was like 4 past the hour or something that you got
just
on it, but.
Program. Just isn't your day.
I have the number 4 in my mind, but I don't know why. Piss off.
This is Director Antaean to all Zerka employees. Please listen and remain calm. A few minutes ago, we experienced a minor equipment failure in the main laboratory. As a precaution, we are initiating lockdown procedures. Do not attempt to override the system so the computers will respond with force. Stay where you are, and you'll be alerted when the situation resolves.
The rebirth has begun. Right, let's go. I'm excited. Let's get this Zerka shit finished. I love the Zerka storyline in the sense that I know that there is more Zerka content later on that I haven't done. So I love Zerka because I get to find... Oh my god, it is going to it. I could get on it. No, but I don't know where it goes. It could take us forever. Never mind. Anyway, what was I saying? Something about Zerka. Yeah. So I like the fact that there is content in the game that I've never done before. I don't know anything about. And it's literally only because Because it's only Zerka. I think that's the only thing that I haven't done before. Oh, that's so annoying. Oh, I was about to say, there must be a way for me to get up there. Okay. Let's do some battling. This is the last thing we need to do on this planet, so let's make the most of it.
Let's settle this.
There's no bonus, which is pissing irritating. No, come here, don't fight Darren. Darren's my boy. Hopefully boyfriend, but I don't know if he's our romantic partner or not. I can't actually remember. Oh look, someone else down there. Looks like he's snuck like round, so I'll still have to fight everything on my way because he won't have done it. Or maybe he went a different way. Vinzozola. Come on, Zerka's droid.
There must be a weakness.
Okay, let's go. I don't think this takes us directly into the story instance. Nah, this does. Let's fight some sort of robot zombies. I think are probably the most accurate description of these things. They walk really slowly and they just sort of punch. They don't have any weapons. It's quite funny. Just keep coming if you take too long, I think. Oh, stop it. He's trying to indoctrinate me. Yeah, okay.
Just isn't your day.
Any green? No, it's just blue. I can handle not doing that. Oh, stop it! I'm saving this because I know in the fight that I'm going to be doing soon, I might need my stun break. Farron, I am going to fire you as my healer if you don't start doing it quicker. That. Green? No, just blue. I love my lightsaber crystal colour so much.
Even for them, I feel tough now, my couple.
I'd welcome the chance to discuss matters with you.
Rabenjinga, Wamagolest Keeper, Ruchi Jasnu, me bag address, Pastiatan Elbin is for Kostinti. Zinieski hid Ruli, does Ruli fehed and Dangwa.
What were you trying to achieve?
Des Matzenke Yujum, Maestra Mehunuba. Even for them, I feel tough now, my couple. Patukche yet me big shuram. Me atena titima.
How do you mean to accomplish that?
Yerke emer zunan ye. Hame kontya estemeta. Habib te gelore, lili bahura bahidye.
So I think the general idea is that they sort of convert you by electrocuting you. I think that's what happened with all the other like Zerker employees. Don't know for certain, but I'm pretty sure that's how the story is trying to tell me that's how it happens. Because all the electricity coming off their bodies a moment ago in the cutscene. I think that's what the developers were trying to get for the story. Come on, Labourer. I should probably use that mass mind control more often. I just never use it, wherever it is. Yeah, that's this one. Just makes everyone... Right, now I can pretty much just ignore all of that. Use whatever heals I can to basically skip past all of it and do this. Because they die instantly once I've sabotaged this. Right, if I can just do this before they come and do that again. Yes. Yes, they immediately, like, die. So if I can just do that again, then it makes it a lot easier. Apologies if that was a bit loud. The more I'm talking, the more I'm getting sick, and I'm really worried. It's got a blood test tomorrow, and I really have got to be up really early for it. Okay, don't interrupt it. Yes. That's all done. Speak to the imprisoned one. Just go up like this. I know it's cheating. Don't care.
Jahil Bastor Zikra.
Marvelous. Absolutely marvelous. We could never have excavated this place without your help. Oh, we knew where the base was, but getting inside, ghastly work. And I should say, I'm delighted to finally meet you in person.
Do you want something from me, Lexende?
You see, when I was assigned to stop the Republic from finding this facility, I was intrigued by the Doomsday device. That my superiors told me to stay away only whet my appetite. I decided to take the device for myself.
You really think you can control its power?
Oh, I'll give it a try. I'm offering a very large sum of credits, as well as rescinding the kill order on Camus, if you help me. Hand over the device, and the Republic never has to know. Tell Fowler you destroyed it. What do you say?
Does this answer your question?
Could you do that? Do you know what that thing was? What it was worth? Oh, now you've left me no choice. I'm going to have to kill you. Painfully.
Really? Somehow I don't think I'm the one that's going to be dying today. That would make for a very interesting story. Lexende. Lexende has the best name, since it sort of sounds like my name, so I love it. Right, speak to Fowler. Is that it now? Am I gone? Sounds like it. Right, all the way back to here. So, Jundland must be like a huge heroic area, unless you come back sometime later or in side quests that we don't do. I've actually rejigged the character that we're going to do next, because I think I said that we were going to do a Sith, and I think I am doing a Sith, but not the Sith that I was going to do. Or I can't actually really remember what I was going to do, but in any case, we're not doing like planet quests again, Dark Side. We're going to do side quests, which is going to be fun, on the next character. Right, Fowler.
Well, if it isn't my favorite Jedi, you look like you just walked out of a sandstorm.
Was there a base? Did you see the device?
Camus was worried that if you failed, it'd mean the end of the world.
Well, you saw Zerka's records.
Yeah, and I've been worried too, so catch your breath and let's hear it.
That device, it had an ancient creature trapped inside. It had gone insane. I had to kill it.
You're kidding. I had no idea. But if it's settled, that's good enough for me.
So this is over? We're sure?
You'll still need to testify, Camus. The investigation of Zerka won't end here.
Get me to Coruscant, away from the Sand People and Zerka cyborg assassins. I'll testify all you want.
You should know. Scanners picked up a Zerka ship fleeing the system. They're running scared now.
Without Lexende, they've lost their claws.
Anyway, I promised you payment. Don't ever say the SIS isn't grateful. Now take care of yourself and try not to get pulled back into these corporate schemes. Camus can tell you, they never really end.
And that's it. We've done Tatooine. I've actually quite liked it. I think I prefer the Tatooine on Republic side than I do on... Well, did I unlock this yet? Oh, can I afford it? Oh, I can afford it. I'm just going to buy it. Fuck it. Okay, so now we've got direct transport to our ship on our map now. Normally that's the first thing I get as soon as I get to about 60,000 credit. I will just buy that straight away because it's so useful and it saves time. That's just saved me about like 5 minutes of actual gameplay by
Welcome
doing that.
Welcome back, Master. If you detect the aroma of Alderaanian nectar,
Master Ares has reported back to the Council. Good work. He speaks of discoveries on Tatooine. We intend to hear his full report when he returns to Coruscant. Did you discover anything more about the Plague Master, this Lord Vivekar?
Master Ares seemed to think that Vivekar was why he kept remembering Malachor III and his friend Parcanus.
A connection between the events on Malachor III and our current circumstances is clearly forming. The Council will continue its own investigation into the matter. Meanwhile, hurry to Alderaan. So long as Lord Vivekar has control of even one master, he will grow in power.
I understand perfectly.
Good. Do not delay. Every wasted moment works in Lord Vivekar's favor.
Cool. And I don't think either of these... I'll do some of these. Critical rating. That's got minus power, though. But it's got more force power. Okay, well, we'll go with this one. Ammo just went up, so that's cool. This does have more damage, so I am going to use it. Just going to take out that. Okay, never mind. I'll just take out another collection. So every time I want another... what am I doing? Every time I want a new saber, I have to go into my collections and get a new crystal, but that I can take out an infinite amount of them, so it doesn't actually really matter, but it's just annoying. Right, who wants to speak to me? Please be Tharren. Please don't be Kaizen. Yeah.
Ah, excellent. We have a mystery. A package was hand-delivered to the ship. No name, aside from mine. No return address. The package contained a letter on flimsyplast, sealed inside a glass capsule. Nothing else.
Maybe the letter has some answers.
The capsule has a marvelously puzzling lock. I've never seen such craftsmanship. Once I get it open and read the letter, hopefully I can assuage my curiosity.
This is so exciting! I wonder who it's from!
Theron's technological work is famous. Perhaps someone's trying to get his attention.
I'll get to work on this lock. If you're right, we'll know soon enough. This is absolutely intolerable. I finally get that blasted capsule's lock open, and the letter inside? Pure gibberish!
Jedi, you can make this all better, can't you?
Listen to this. AH320SH4. And that's just one line!
The message is probably encrypted.
Yes, that's occurred to me too. But all our deciphering attempts have failed. AH3. This isn't a message, it's a chemical formula! And the letter itself smells strange. I thought it was the capsule, but what if applying the chemical to the letter had some effect?
That formula looks very complex, and you don't have a laboratory.
Hmm. An excellent point.
Oh, let me make that chemical. I can do it in a snap, and I simply have to know what's on that letter. I'll get started right away.
At last, an answer. However do you do it? Your very presence sparks my inspiration.
Does my presence spark anything else?
You bring out the very best in me, Jedi. You have ever since Nar Shaddaa. Let me express my gratitude properly. In private, perhaps.
You really are full of good ideas.
Then let's find somewhere to get acquainted. You are a rare find in this galaxy. I regret that I must leave such delectable company so soon, but work calls. Until later, my Jedi.
FYI, I mean, I'm not assuming that I just chose for us to do something in particular, but I'm assuming, I mean, it has to be, right? That sounded like we just had a hookup, but I don't know for certain if that is true or not. Well, we're nearing the end of the episode, so I'm just going to, you know what, I think I'll end the episode here, so the next episode we will find out what we're doing on Alderaan. Yeah, so thank you very much for watching, and tune in next time.